Hey guys, today I'm going to cover a new segment I created called More Than Dogs Archives, or MTD Archives. And today's topic is how I interpret business profit. So if you stick with me to the end, you're going to learn about the different types of business profit, how it helps us make decisions, how to leverage each type of profit for decision making, and what tools do we use to obtain that information. I'm also going to provide an example that I actually use in my business to make a decision using gross profit. But before we get started, there's likely a lot of stuff that I didn't cover here. So let me know in the comments what you want to learn about. It doesn't have to be about profit. Doesn't have to be about the business side of things. It could be literally anything. Just let me know. And please hit the subscribe button to my channel. I literally Googled this, right? To subscribe means to arrange to receive something regularly. So if I've earned that from you, I'd love to know about it. So, all right, the types of business profit. I have, at a high level, gross profit, and that is the money left over after subtracting the cost of goods sold from your revenue. Okay, cost of goods sold is commonly referred to as COGS. The net operating income, that is the money left over after subtracting COGS and operating expenses. Operating expenses are the additional costs associated with running your business, so it's not necessarily a cost that goes into what it takes to produce a product, but is an associated and necessary expense to operate. Then we have net income, which is just one level deeper. It's the money left over after subtracting your cost of goods sold, your operating expenses, and other expenses associated with the business, but not necessarily tied to operating. And both of those terms are all profit. They're just different fancy versions of profit layered deeply so that you can see different forms of profit, right? Like, how is a business doing on a one-to-one, like, I sell a product, here's the cost of the product. How is doing on what it takes to go in to make all of that happen? And then how's it doing on a full circle, right? So it's just layers of profit. Our common uses. Okay. So for gross profit, we use this most often for real-time decisions, like how do we project a single-day goal, a single-day break-even point, adding a new item to the menu for this event or for the next month. And that's also good for us to use in hindsight when we're trying to decide if items are worth their time and effort. When it comes to net operating income, this is great for reverse engineering scenarios. So you could start with a revenue and reverse engineer that and the expenses to develop like a monthly, quarterly, or yearly goal. It's good for analyzing additional expenses that might be eating away at your business. It helps you decide, what can I change here where expenses are high? Can I substitute this for something cheaper? Do I really need this? What can I eliminate without removing the quality? So when it comes to net income, I like to use this for reverse engineering true business profit, right? Like how much is left over at the very end. This helps to develop goals for reinvestment and expansion. And also it's a marker for your own personal income, right? Like if you're taking home money and you want to take home more money, like what are the goals involved to make that happen for you? All right. Now, when it comes to key decision making, profit helps you create big answers to big questions. So for us in the mobile food industry, some of those questions are, should I add a new item to the menu? Should I stop selling an item? How much revenue do I need to break even? How much revenue do I need to achieve my goals? And it's important to note here that there are always going to be other variables involved. We never actually only look at business profit, right? There's a lot of things that go into the business world. It's not black and white, and that's why it's not easy. But profit's never going to be the only thing we consider. Some of the other things we look at, especially in our industry, right? It's the length of time from when we start to prep to the actual event, to the actual cleanup. Like how long is that day? What is the effort that goes into it? In relation to profit, right? If I was going to make $50, you know, across a 10-hour day, and that was my projection, it would be a no-go, right? But if I was going to make $50 for 45 minutes of work or something, it's like, okay, I can do this. So it's all relative. You got to consider if you need workers, how many employees do you need? Is it just you or is it you and a business partner working it? What is the type of event? Where's the location of the event? How far are you driving? There's liability on the road. Lots of things to think about when you consider profit. All right, so easily accessible tools to leverage. Tools to leverage for profit analysis. For us, we like to use Google Sheets, Square. You can use a similar POS software or QuickBooks Online or a similar software. With Google Sheets, right? That is like the online version of Excel. It has a lot of capabilities. It's always getting better. You can get a G Suite account for the lowest there is $6 a month, and that comes with an email as well, right? So you can set up like iamjoey@morethandogs.com using Gmail G Suite services, and that comes with, I think, an entire terabyte, which is a lot of data storage. And that comes with, you know, the entire suite of Google Slides and Docs and Sheets and everything. So it's great. Square is good for our reporting software and POS. So like that's how we process payments and that's how we look at a lot of our sales data. QuickBooks Online is our accounting software. That is where we're recording and documenting all of our receipts, our expenses, so we can actually dive into some of this data. Without a lot of this, you're doing it manually by hand or not at all, so you can't answer some of these questions. It gets harder and harder to improve your business when you don't have the information at your fingertips. And I think our tier of QuickBooks Online is $32 a month. Square, you can have the free tier. We just went through our first year of paying like 300 something for the year. And then again, I mentioned what it costs to get started with G Suite. So here's a real example of how I use gross profit in my business. The question: should we stop selling an item? That item is a Tom Tom Tamale because in Chicago, it's a local thing in a lot of the areas. The Tom Tom Tamale is popular. It's like a prepackaged fast food version of tamale. It's not authentic. It's more of like a ballpark fast food thing that's popular here. It's okay. Like I like a Tom Tom Tamale every now and then, but it's not my favorite food. So and my partner, Mike, he doesn't really like them at all. So we have these mixed feelings about it. The problem is we waste a lot of Tom Toms because we don't sell them at a fast enough pace. We keep them frozen so they don't spoil and go bad. So we preserve them, right? And to go from frozen to a fully steamed tamale, it takes longer than if it was thawed, right? That's a given. So because of that, we always have to have a couple ready, 2 to 4 at least, right? Because they take longer to cook and we don't want customers waiting forever just for a $3 item. They're greasy. They're the only greasy item in our steamers, so they create a mess. And overall, we're just a little bit frustrating with handling them. And as an owner, we can do whatever we want, right? Well, we'll let profit decide, because even though we could do whatever we want, what if the profit is too great to change my perspective? Like, oh, this, is it really that much of a hassle? Or you know what, I only made a couple $100 on this the entire year. I'll skip this and I'll go harder on hot dogs or something like that. So I'm going to now jump over to my screen where I'm sharing what I'm doing in QuickBooks and Square, and then we'll come back and discuss the decision. All right. So like I said before, we use QuickBooks. This is our software, accounting software choice. It's affordable. It's easy, usable. You can learn things about it. You can YouTube stuff about it. It's not the greatest, but it gets the job done for a small business. So I'm going to go into reports, which is where I'm at. I'm looking at our profit loss report. I'm going to filter from March 27, 2023 to October 31st, 2023, because that's pretty much our operating season. We do things outside of those months, but if I want to get the quickest and easiest look at what our tamales have costed us, this is what I'm going to look at. So I filter this and I'm on my cost of goods sold. I'm going to scroll down. You can see here for tamales for the season, we've spent $862.36. So the way we have things set up, we now would use our Square reporting to pull in our revenue and determine that, because the integration between Square and QuickBooks is kind of funky. So we broke the integration and we just kind of bring in our income by the day or by the event or by the week, month, etc. So to get it on the specific item, we're now going to go over to Square. We'll grab that number and we'll do our quick calculation and figure out our gross profit and determine if we want to keep tamales on the menu. So now I have net sales in here because this is with tax taken out. So I want sales tax taken out because that is not a factor in gross profit, because the tax is not yours. It goes to the government. So I'm by category sales again because I want to know tamales in general. I don't want to know a single Tom Tom tamale in a wrapper. I want to know a Tom Tom tamale with however we sell it. So that's why I have it filtered by categories and again by our operating season this past year. So now if I filter and scroll down to tamales, you can see we brought in $3,998.66. And we brought in, I think we spent 800 and something. So there's clearly profit there. Let's go back and analyze that. All right, so I took you through the profit analysis, and that was this right here. I pulled up the cost of goods sold on TomTom Tamales for the year. All right, I found that in the accounting software, which is QuickBooks. I pulled up the sales for the year on this specific item. I could see that in Square. I calculated the profit, the gross profit. I made a decision. Is this a significant amount of profit? Does it change the way I feel about what I'm selling? And would it hurt my business to take that item away? Here's the answers. The answer, we're keeping TomToms on the menu, but the plan is to revise the menu and shorten our offerings. So currently, our menu is like half variations of TomTom tamales. It's a TomTom tamale, it's a mother-in-law, which is a tamale on a bun with chili, and then it's a father-in-law, a tamale on a bun with chili and cheese, and then there's a tamale boat. And there's all these variations, and the truth is, they're very popular only to locals, and locals are going to know that if they see tamale boat on the menu, they're going to know we have tamales. So if they just want a tamale, or they just want a tamale on a bun, then we can give that to them. We just don't need to take up space on our menu with it. So our plan is to shorten our offerings and just put tamale boat on the menu. And we've decided we've made too much profit to let our own frustrations get in the way of our customer demands. So the tamale revenue for that season was just shy of $4,000, and we spent $862 on it. So that's $3,136 in gross profit on tamales alone. That's not insignificant, especially for our mobile food business. We're not making millions in this industry. And that cost of goods sold on tamales includes waste. It includes the ones that we threw out. So it's worth it. All right, well, let's see. What else is there? What else is there for me? What do you want to learn about? What do you want to know? How can I help you? And that's it, guys, really. Stay tuned for the next couple videos. I think we have some things we're covering on a business who's trying to ramp up their volume, and they're, you know, it takes some time. And how do you preserve your food? How do you go from frozen to cooked in a few minutes? So we'll be dropping that soon. Let me know. Please, again, subscribe to my channel if we're adding value to you, because we're trying to teach you what we do so you guys can do it too.